Welcome to a new video which is about properties of limits. In this video I will show you the main rules besides some challenging questions that you may encounter when solving limit questions. If this is your first time here and if you want to support this channel, don't forget to subscribe, click on the bell to turn on the notifications to be aware of the upcoming videos. We have a lot to cover, so let's get started. Here we have properties about limits. Suppose that C, K, L, M, they are all real numbers as it is written here. Also suppose that limit of f of x when x goes to c, c is a constant number here, and that can be evaluated as by just putting c instead of x here. So this is equal to f of c, and there is, let's say, L. L is a real number here. And the same thing, we have another limit when x goes to c, the limit of g of x, which is equal to g of c, and let's say this is also equal to m. In this case, limit of any constant number, c is a constant here, when x goes to k, k might be any real number, and in this case, the result is always equal to that constant number c. If you have two functions like this, okay, and if there's a plus sign between them, the limit is equal to the summation of each function. And if there is a subtraction between the functions, and the limit is equal to subtracting of both limits. And if there is such a constant k, because the limit of f of x is going to be equal to L, so we just multiply that k by the limit value to obtain the result. I will already solve related questions about these properties. I just want to show you the second part of the properties also. If we multiply the functions and then multiply the limit results as well. If we divide those functions, then we can divide the results of the limits as well. And if we take the nth power of the function, then we just take the nth power of the result of the limit. If we take the nth root of the function, then we just take the nth root of the value of the limit also. Let's take a look at the related examples for these properties. For our first question, it says find the limits below. As you can see, in the first option we have limit of 20 when x goes to 5. That number is not important actually. X can go wherever, doesn't matter. Here in this case the limit is exactly 20, guys. And in the next case it says when x goes to negative 1, what is the limit of this? Normally you can write that this is equal to limit of x squared when x goes to negative 1 minus 3 times limit of x when x goes to negative 1 plus limit of 4 when x goes to negative 1. You can write it like that. As you can see, it takes time, but you can also put negative 1 instead of x. Once you put negative 1 instead of x, then we're gonna have, just let me write it exactly here in a faster way. So it's gonna be 1, negative 3 times negative 1 is gonna be positive 3 plus 4, and that is gonna be 8, guys. And you can do the same thing here. If you put negative 1 instead of x, x squared is gonna be 1 minus 3 times, once you put negative 1 instead of x, then it's gonna be negative 3. So if you multiply it by negative 3, it's gonna be positive 3 plus, and from the last term we can easily get 4, and still we get the same answer as 8. And we can do the same thing for c here. Okay, this is going to be equal to 2 times limit of x when x goes to 2 minus limit when x goes to 2 of, so once you put 2 instead of x, then we're going to have logarithm of 5 in base 5, and from here we get 1, guys. So the result is 2 times 2, 4, 4 minus 1, which gives us the answer as 3, guys. For D, I'll just plug 4 in x. Okay, once you do it, just put this 4 instead of x here. 2 times 4, 8, 8 plus 1 is 9, square root of 9, and then let me write the rest here. Square root of 9 minus 7, guys, which is 3 minus 7, and the result is negative 4, guys, in this case. And let's continue with the next question. In this question it says if limit of f of x when x goes to 2 and the result is 3, and if limit of g of x when x goes to same 2, that is important, if this is 4, and then find the result of this limit. Well, we can rewrite this question, okay, as in the following way. 3 times limit of f of x when x goes to 2. minus 2 times limit of g of x when x goes to same 2. What is the result of this expression? We can interpret this question like this. This part is already given to us as 3, and that part is already given to us as 4. So once you put those values in these expressions, then we're going to have 3 times 3 minus 2 times 4, and that is going to be 9 minus 8, which gives us the answer as 1, guys. And let's continue with the next question. Okay, we have a new question, and it says, when x goes to 3, find the limit of this logarithm. All we need to do is just, you know, put 3 instead of x. That's all what we're going to do. So this is going to be equal to, guys, logarithm in base 2. And the number is just put 3 instead of x. Then we're going to have 5 times 3 squared is 9 plus 3 divided by 3, guys. So this is going to be equal to logarithm in base 2. Okay, 5 times 9 is 45, 45 plus 3, which is 48 divided by 3, guys. And that is logarithm in base 2, 16. And 16 is what? Logarithm in base 2, 2 to the power of 4. If you remember, that 4 was coming in front of logarithm, so it's going to be equal to 4 times logarithm of 2 in base 2, and that part is 1, so the result is 4 times 1, which is 4, guys, which gives us the answer as B. And let's continue with the next question. We have a new question. There are 3 functions given to us, and we are asked to find the value of limit of f of x times g of x divided by h of x when x goes to 2. So basically, we can write this function as following. Limit of f of x when x goes to 2 times limit of g of x when x goes to 2 divided by limit of h of x when x goes to 2, guys. So basically, I'm gonna just evaluate those functions at the point x is equal to 2. That's it. So put just 2 instead of x for the first limit, okay? And once you do it, we're gonna have 2 squared, which is 4, minus 2 plus 1 times g of x, put just 2 instead of x, and once you do it, you're gonna have logarithm of 2 to the power of 3, which is 8, 8 plus 2, which is 10, divided by, just put 2 instead of x, so it's going to be 4h of x, I'm talking about the denominator, and it's going to be 2 plus 2, guys. And once you do it, we're going to have, in the numerator part, 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 times, this is logarithm 10, guys. And if you remember, in logarithm series, we said that if there is no any base in logarithms, that means the base is 10, guys. So this is already 1, and the denominator is 4, so the result is 3 over 4, guys. And let's continue with the next question. And we have a new question. It says, f is a function from real numbers to the real numbers. And we have 2 definitions. Limit of f of x when x goes to 3 from the right side, that is important. From the right side, and in this case the result is negative 1. For the next definition, limit of f of x when x goes to 3 from the left, the value is negative 2. In this case, when x goes to 2 from the right side, what is the value of f of 2x minus 1 plus f of 5 minus x divided by f of x squared minus 1? I put this question here so that it's a little bit different from what I solved and what you can see on the books, so that it's a different kind of questions and you can apply the same methodology in similar questions as well. Once you put 2 instead of x inside this whole expression, okay, let's see what we get from this. I'm going to just write this immediately. I'm going to put just 2 inside the x values in functions, guys. So once you do it, we're going to have f of 2 times 2 is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. But because of that approaching 2 from the right, we're going to have something like this. 3 plus, guys, plus f of, if you put 2, but it's going to be 2 plus means approaching 2 from the right, so just put 2.01. And once you subtract this from 5, this is of course f, and then we're going to have f of 2.99, guys. You can think of it in this way. So this is almost this, because this is just an approaching value. X value is not exactly 2.01, so I'm just putting here as an approximated value when it comes to limit. So, and this is like, equal to, guys, f of 3 from the left. So I'm gonna put here 3 from the left divided by the same thing is here, okay, f of x squared minus 1. Just put 2 from the right and it's gonna be 4 f of 4 minus 1, but because this is the plus, so it's gonna be 4.01 approximately. So you can think it as, let's say, approximately this is 3.01, okay? So this is like 3 plus. You can think it in this way. Let me put it here first, 3 plus, which means approaching 3 from the right side. And once you plug those values that are given to us, then we're gonna have negative 1 plus 3 minus is negative 2 divided by f of 3 approaching from the right, which means negative 1. And that is negative 3 over negative 1, which gives us the answer as positive 3, guys. So the result is C in this case. And let's take a look at our last question in this video. We have a function f of x, which is defined from real numbers to real numbers, and its graph is given to us. And in math, this symbol is for every, guys. For every. So for every x1, which is from real numbers, there is a function g of x, which is defined as g of x1, and that is f of x1 plus limit when x goes to x1 plus f of x. If this is the case, we are asked to find the value of this composite function. So let me write it here, g of, this is g of f of 2 actually. Okay, so let me write it again. This is g of f of 2. So we will find out what is f of 2 first, by using f of x function, and as you can see, f of 2 is here. At the point x is equal to 2, the value of y is 0. So this is 0, guys. So actually, we are asked to find the value of g of 0 and what it is. And by using this g of function, okay, I'm gonna find what it is. So I'll just put 0 instead of x1 here, and once you do it, we're gonna have g of 0 is f of 0 plus limit when x goes to 0 from right f of x, guys. So what is this? We are going to look for the value of this expression. So f of 0 is, as you can see, it's defined here because of this closed value, shaded value. So from here we have negative 1 plus limit of f of x when x goes to 0 from right. The same thing, guys. This is the function. I'm coming over the f of function, approaching 0. As you can see, this is the origin 0. And at this point, we have also another negative 1. So negative 1, that gives us the answer as negative 2, guys. And in this video, I try to solve different kind of questions. I hope you like it. If you have any questions, you can put them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and hopefully see you in the upcoming videos.